Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel Topper's World. In this session of video, I'm sharing reading, listening and speaking tips. If you are seriously making efforts for 7 or 8 band in listening, reading and speaking, I think this video will be of great use to you. So first, I'm sharing tips regarding reading. My first tip is that you need to read a variety of texts. If you are a science student, then you should read texts related to economics, business, history, and vice versa. If you are a history student, then try to read the topics on science and technology. Most of the topics in the academic reading are related to science and technology. And in case of general, you should go for various types of passages like on sports, on health, on exercise, various type of. And these things you can find out in the magazines, newspapers. Daily spend 20-30 minutes on reading something interesting, like related to your area of interest. Maybe that could be related to films or music or adventure or sports. And you can also read textbooks, blogs, articles for this. And this is not simply reading. When you find some difficult words over there, so underline those words, write them on any copy. And in this way, you should prepare your own dictionary, your own collection of vocabulary, and search the meaning through Google or any other dictionary and write the sentences. This will develop your vocabulary at a very fast pace. It has been seen that the words that we read in any text, that words we remember for a longer period of time instead of simply getting a collection of words. So next thing that you need to do is try different kind of techniques or strategies for reading. Like you can someday read only third passages for a couple of days, as the third passage is the most difficult one. Or you can try for reading first passage for a couple of days. If you are a beginner, then I want that you should focus more on first passage, then move to second, then third. I mean to say that for 2-3 weeks, you should read first passage of every test. Then you move to second and third. If you're already good enough in English and your target score is 7 or 8, then you should pay special attention to section 3, because that is the hardest passage. The next thing is you should discuss your passages or something that you read with any partner. Discussions improve interest in reading and memory power, and also exchange of ideas will help you to develop your English level. Another thing is, it's very important to read at speed. So try to read the passages, like first passage in 10 minutes, second in 12 or 13 minutes, and daily record how many questions you are able to read. In the beginning, you might be slow, because at that time you need to pay more attention on understanding rather than speed. But gradually speed up. Try to read 4 or 5 words in one glance. And try to ignore certain words, mainly focus on nouns and verbs, and avoid reading difficult names or names of institutions, scientists, names of clubs, name of organizations that have nothing to do with answers. So if you find so many difficult words in one passage, you can ignore some words because all the words you need not to understand. But if you are at the beginning and want to improve your vocabulary, at that time you have to be slow. But after a certain period of time, like after 1 month or 2 months, you need to speed up. Then you should familiarize with the different style of questions. Like if the questions are blanks, then how to find out the blanks? You need to read first and the last word first and the next word to the blank, and to try to find out the articles, grammar, try to find out any adverb or adjective used over there, search for those words by scanning and skimming in the passage. So multiple choice questions are there, list of headings, which paragraph contain what kind of information. So these are many types of questions, and you should be familiar with all these types of questions. And if you are facing any difficulty regarding any particular type of question, for example, you are not able to do list of headings, then I want that you should start from some easy books. Like you can take books of general IELTS. General IELTS books are easier, and you should practice a list of heading from those books in the beginning, and after you will realize that your level will go up slowly and then shift to or switch to some difficult books for list of heading type of questions. So in this way you can improve your reading. Along with that, I want that you should special pay attention towards your vocabulary is really very important. If you are not able to improve your vocabulary, the score in reading will remain fluctuating at a certain level. After that, you will not be able to, you know, cross that border limit. So vocab should be improved. Then regarding listening, now for listening, what you need to do, you need to make some special efforts, like listening more podcasts, watching BBC channel, news channels, and also practicing listening. Suppose you take any listening test and you get score less than 50, or you get score less above than 90% score. For example, out of 40, if your score is 12 or 13, it means that the listening is very difficult for your level. So you should change that. Start from easier one. And if your score is above 30, above 35, then it means that it's too easy. You should go for difficult listening. Okay, then I would like to suggest to you that you should focus on spellings. Spellings are really very important in listening, whether you're very intelligent in English or little bit weak. Spellings is a problem of everybody. Spelling of English are a little bit tricky, and we are not able to sometimes make judgment right. Is it double E or IE? They are very confusing. Even expert English language user also get mistakes in this. So prepare a list of words that often gives you problems, and just watch them 2-3 times in a day so that the spellings can be stored in your brain. So in this way, the problem of spelling can be sorted out. In listening, guessing is very important. When you read the question, think about that, what kind of answer can be there. If there is a filling the blank, then think about that, what word would be filled there. Like for example, it's a date, or it's a amount, or it is any name, or name of any newspaper, movie, something like that. Means when you read the question, read it deeply to and assess that what kind of answers can be filled over there. This kind of practice and planning always help you to focus on the right kind of information that you have to listen. While listening, you will also come across with lots of difficult words. Ignore those words. All those words are not you need to understand. You just focus on that part of the information which is required for the answer. I have seen that some students make very quick judgments when they just listen a part of the conversation and they quickly write the answer. It has been seen that many times the speakers in the listening change their point by using however, but, or many other words. So you should listen till end, be patient while answering. Do not take quick decisions like, okay, this is the answer. Later on, you might find that after 4-5 sentences, they take a U-turn in the answer. So that can be problematic for you. So need to practice these kind of things. So observe patience level. For listening and reading answers, handwriting is very important. And take care if your R, letter S, letter U, letter V, usually the students write in the same shape. I suggest you that you should practice a couple of days writing in capital letters. In listening, you must write capital letters so that examiner or the checker of your task should be able to read your answers correctly. A number of times have been seen that the students write correct answer by their side, but the handwriting is such a poor handwriting that they lose the marks because they are not legible. They are not easily be read by the examiner. Suppose you do any listening and you make 25 correct answers, and still there are 15 answers that you are not able to understand or you are not able to listen properly. So what you need to do, you listen that section again in which you made maximum mistakes. keep on repeating that section till your mistakes are zero. So then you move to the next test. It's not beneficial that you do only 20 correct and after that you change the test. You have to focus on the problem areas and keep revising till you are 100% correct in listening. So as far as speaking is concerned, I personally believe that those who are able to listen well, they should be able to speak well, because listening and speaking are both activities which depend on each other. It's a mutual depending activities. So more listen than more speak. Whatever you listen, try to say in the same style. Suppose you watch any English movie, try to copy them, do the mimicry of them. It can be funny, but it's a good way to learn the style of pronunciation and learn the style of expressing the emotions in English language. Actually, we are the natives of Punjab, so our emotions we can better express in Punjabi language. And when we try to express in English, there is a mismatch. And that mismatch can be, you know, declined, or, you know, we can remove if we copy the style of conversation of Western people, especially the English speaking people. Try to listen more and more people of different kind of accent, like Americans, like Australians or Africans, those who are good in English. Watch more podcasts, more interesting videos on motivational speaking that will help you to develop your confidence. And make a group of friends. Try to talk with each other in English. Fixed hours a day that in these hours we have to talk only in English. You can also make a phone call to customer care executives of different companies. They are very good in English. You can talk to them. You can take information about their products. They feel good with this, and this will also help you to boost your confidence level in speaking. Try to learn those words which are related to topic specific word, because in IELTS different kind of topics in speaking are asked, like related to jewelry, related to movies, related to news or entertainment, restaurant, food. So try to make a collection of words related to different kind of topics. If you are talking about food, then you should learn words like cuisine, the word like delicious, different kind of foods, their names and the style of cooking. Health related vocabulary is different, food related different, related to agriculture and environment. Try to make a collection of 20 to 30 words of each topic in any copy or register, and revise them on your daily basis and use them in your language. So in this way you will be able to master speaking. And then confidence level is required at the time of speaking. So try to establish eye contact with the examiner, have a smile on the face. These are the normal things that you already know. The most important thing is vocabulary and sentence making skill. A formation of sentence, you should have variety of sentences, like simple sentences, passive voice. Complex sentences are very important and they are very impressive in speaking. So take care of all these things and you will be able to get your dream score 7 or 8 band. So thank you for watching this video, and if you like this video, write in the comment box. And if you find something wrong in this video, then please also comment in the comment box that where I made mistake. So thank you for watching. Have a nice day.